What's up, guys? You're Doomsday here, and we are back with some top lane CP Reza. So, I just want to get some gameplay out or get a video out or something for y'all while I make the video for the lane exchange one in the laning phase. So, we're going to start off with a crystal bit and book, and we are going to be going up to top lane. Pretty much, the enemy team is actually pretty good. I think most of them are VG Silver already. I haven't played enough to get to VG Silver yet, but I'll get there eventually, probably soon. A couple days. But I'm gonna start off a lane, and I'm gonna go ahead and push that in. I just like doing that first. Just because, since now jungle ambient is so low, I just like lane more, to be honest. But this patch though, I've noticed that top lane's just been super hard, and it's so hard to hold turret. Like, it's pretty much impossible if the enemy's good to hold turret, because you have like two ranged people just attacking your turret and sieging you. You can't really do much. But I just have to last hit the minions, and then I'm gonna see if I should grab my healer or not, or see what I need to do. Wow, that actually did no damage. I swear, I thought that my A did more damage than that. That's so weird. I actually thought that that would have been enough to last hit that minion. I guess your A doesn't do as much damage to start off with, but definitely thought it did some. Oh, that's fine. So we're trying to grab our healer now, and we see that Vox is coming up to lane, and so is Silvernail. So that's going to be annoying to lane against, just because they're going to put so much pressure. It looks like they're invading our CP. I'm going to go and collapse on him. We should be able to win a 3v2 if we play it right. They should come this way. As long as all three of us come here. We need to focus on Moline. They're focusing Churnwalker. That was actually a bad trade. I might be dead here, actually. I'll live. I thought we could have done that, actually. I think if we all went in at the same time, instead of actually splitting up, and we actually all focused the same target, I think we could have won that, but right now, top lane's just getting destroyed like always. I'm probably gonna lose turret, and our bottom lane's probably gonna get turret soon too. Wait, what? Our bot lane already got turret? Okay. Scarf jungle is actually so good this patch, just because you can take turrets so quickly. But I'm just gonna try and put some damage on Silvernail, just because I want them to kind of back off, and they aren't even really doing anything. That silence is so annoying, though. I have to go all the way around it. I even lost my big minion for that. I don't have flask. Looks like Kinetic's pinging Scarf to come this way. But I lost turret here, but that's kind of normal now. I'm not sure how it is if you play another server, but an NA server, normally most people just lose turret about 3 minutes or so. It's kind of normal. I really want to go in on Silvernail, but he still has flask, so I can't do that. You always got to keep track of people's flask, because if you don't, you can go for some stupid play like this, where it seems that he's so low, but they still have flask. I'm gonna actually go back and shop really quickly, because I can't do anything right now with no health. So now that I've shopped, I know I could put some pressure on him. Looks like Kinetic's going up there. If Kinetic can stop their recall. Ooh, nice. I'm gonna boots just because I want to get over there as quick as I can. I don't know if... Oh my god, I missed my A. I'm not gonna even go for Silvernail here. I'm gonna go straight for Vox if I can. Can I get Vox? Nice, I got that. I'm just gonna have to run now. The reason why I went for Vox is because First Blood gives so much gold. Like, I got like 400 gold from that, and our entire team got like 150 each. That is an insane amount of gold. And that's why I just chose to go for Vox instead, just because I wanted First Blood. But hopefully we can push this minion wave underneath turret. And then I probably want to recall after this. Oh my god, I was trying to get that minion. That was really bad. I thought that Kinetic was going to get it. Well, it looks like Kinetic took a bunch of my farm, actually, but that's fine. We'll see how it goes. Since I got a kill, it's fine if they take it. I still have plenty of gold. But I'm just going to head back up here. I think that Silvernail should rotate to jungle in a second, because you know that their jungle is up. So you want to predict where they're going, and right now, I know He's probably gonna go straight to jungle. Yup. So now it's safe to clear lane. Just because I knew that their jungle was spawning, and pretty much nobody ever solo clears jungle. Usually a bot laner's always with them, so I knew he was about to go and clear that. So you always want to keep stuff like that in mind. But I'm just gonna push this wave out, and by the time I push this out, they should be back in lane. They should be coming here like any second now. Looks like our mid laner's actually getting destroyed. Maybe I can get churn. He might still have flask. I might just be debating myself here. Oh my god, why am I going all in? Oh crap, he still has flask. Whoops. I kind of just trolled there. Do not do what I did, please. I took the risk that he didn't have flask, which was probably a stupid risk, but normally with your team, or if you like ever like voice chat with people, normally it's easier if you just say. That's why it's so important to just like convey with each other if they still have flask or not, because if I'd known turn walker had flask there, I probably wouldn't have done that, but I don't know, I just got kind of greedy. I definitely shouldn't have done that. That was kind of stupid. I should be able to beat Silvernail. Right when I hit level 6, I'm going to go in on Silvernail, but I can't before level 6. I'm just going to try and use my A ability to get my perk on and then basic attack him once. Now that I'm level 6, I'm going to go right in on him. Oh, I'm going to have to ultimate over the wall. He's about to ultimate me. I could tell. I know he's about to. I'm waiting for it. Oh, he was too late. But pretty much there, what I did was I knew I couldn't beat a Silvernail at level 5 since I was still level 5 at the beginning. So what I was doing was I was just waiting for my level 6 and I would just use my A ability to 1, do some damage, 2, it applies my perk, and then once you apply your perk, you always want to try and just basic attack him one time just to get that huge burst of damage. It did like a third of his health and it was so nice. And then right when I got level 6, I got my ultimate, so I knew that that's a really good power spike for Reza. So I chose to go in on him. And I knew that I can't go over the tripwire. I'm going to rotate to mid here, actually. I knew that I couldn't go over the tripwire, so they're putting a lot of pressure on mid. Hopefully, I could just force him off. I doubt I can kill anybody since it's a Moline, but I just want to force him off in mid. Hopefully, let our Idris get farmed. Okay, yep, that was all I wanted to do. Now I can head back up to top. I'm actually going to recall just because I have no energy. Kind of just want to go back. But I couldn't use my B ability to go over Silvernail's tripwire, so I just had to use my ultimate. And then I was waiting for the ultimate. You always want to think about what the enemy is doing next. I knew he was going to try and ultimate me. And if he did get the ultimate off on me, I was prepared what to do. What I would have done was I would have boosted and then used my B ability to get back on him. You always got to be ready for whatever the enemy is going to do. It looks like Vox is actually caught out here. That should be a free kill. But you always got to be prepared for what the enemy is going to do and predict what they're going to do. That's the most important thing. So if you just predict what the enemy is going to do and play it right, you could easily do it. Right now, this kinetic's taking all my farm, which is kind of annoying, but it is what it is. I'm not going to ping spam anybody. Okay, now that I'm not going to even try and last hit that over a scarf and a kinetic. I'm going to try and go on Silvernail. Yeah, he still had boots. That's fine. If he didn't boots, probably could have killed him. I might have been able to kill him anyways, but oh, watch this. Watch this. Let's try this. Vox is going to walk right around me, and Silvernail is going to walk right past me, and I'm going to kill him. Please do not come this bush, Vox. Dang it. No, I missed my A ability. He's going to ultimate me. I'm about to get ultimate. Oh, he misses. Oh, I still can't get him. Yeah, I just wanted to see if I could do that there. Normally, you probably shouldn't try that, but I want to see if I could get it. Vox kind of ruined it by walking into that bush, and I kind of ruined it by missing my A. If I hadn't missed my A, I definitely could have gotten that. That was bad on my part. Okay, I'm going to stop trying this kind of stuff now. Half of these things I'm doing are kind of bad. I'm going to actually start playing pretty good now. But I'm going to hit to mid, see if we can get a kill on Vox or anyone here. I could definitely just delete Vox here. Oh, looks like Scarf's got him, actually. Oh, there's going to be nothing left for me. That sucks. Oh, everybody's already dead. Oh, I could just ultimate over this wall. Nice. I doubt we can get the silver now. Yep. Pretty much back there, I just wanted to see if I could do it. That was probably not the most intelligent play, but it would have been cool if it worked out, but that's fine. Better luck next time, I guess. Should have hit my A. Sylvanel's coming this way. I'm just gonna leave. Yeah, Malene's here too. I don't wanna, it's very easy to get caught out by Sylvanel and a Malene, so it's not even worth trying to go for the steal. Instead, I'm just gonna clear my wave. But anyways, I haven't even talked about my build. What am I doing? So, the build I'm going with on Reza is Spellfire, Clockwork, Broken Myth. I have seen this build lately, and it looks pretty good, so thought I'll just try it out. We're just gonna have to clear a wave here. It looks like they're putting a lot of pressure in bottom lane. That's pretty nice. I'm just gonna push out this wave and then try to rotate somewhere if I can. Okay, I'm gonna try and rotate. I'm just gonna grab my healer here. You just wanna farm up as much as you can. Looks like they're putting good pressure in mid. That's good. They're behind at first in mid, actually, really badly. We were losing. But then with a couple good fights, we actually got ahead. Looks like I'm just gonna check out their CP buff, I guess. There isn't much for me to do right now. I'm just gonna see if I can catch someone out over here. Some people were low around here, so I'm just gonna bush camp over here. If somebody happens to walk this way and they're low, I'll just delete them. Sylvanel's not low enough. Yeah, he's not alone too. I don't want to go out there with the Baptiste. Baptiste is such a good counter to Reza. It's just so annoying, just because it actually locks his mobility down. But I'm just gonna try and use my A ability to poke at him. We should be able to win a poke match, just because we have so much damage for poke. And Lyra can help us sustain, so if we just keep on poking at him, we can definitely win this. And they'll definitely get lower. Oh, looks like we died in bottom lane. Kinetic actually died to Baptiste. Let's see if I can actually maybe get Vox here. Vox is kind of low, actually. Never mind, there's still four of them there. I don't want to go in on a 3v4. I think our kinetic's kind of tilted right now. So that's fine. Ooh, I can definitely... Oh, I can get a kill there. That guy's so overextended. Oh, he's dead for sure. If he tries to ultimate me, I'll use my own ultimate to drop. That's nice. Pretty much there. Baptiste was overextended, and the only way I could have seen a Baptiste getting out of that is if he uses his ultimate to try to force us off, but if you're ready for it and you're actually expecting it, I could have just used my own ultimate to dodge it, and then I would have been fine. But with Sylvanel in top lane, we could definitely go for this objective, because right now they're split and they have one dead. We should be able to get this. Should just focus dragon right now, and if they come closer, then we can go on them. Oh, that guy's too close. I'm gonna try and go on to him. That was a lot of damage, to be honest. Oh, they just fountained. Oh, I'm just gonna back off. Whoa, what the? Wait, what? Can somebody please tell me what just happened there? The Baptiste ult made me go forward. Okay, I'm gonna have to rewatch that after this and see what happened. I don't know what happened there. I was running away. And next thing I know, I got Baptiste ulted, which normally would have pushed me back more and would have actually been kind of helpful, but instead it, like, pulled me forward. I'm not sure if that was a glitch or something, but we should just go for Blacklaw or Ghosting here. That's the safe call right now. With Kinetic just split pushing, we can't win a fight in mid right now, and we should just go for this. Looks like their Malene is their most fed person. Getting a couple kills on Sylvanel really, really gets you ahead. Kills are so important in this patch. They're worth so much gold. If you get kills, you can get ahead of your enemy bot or the enemy laner in general just so easily, and it's so nice. But I'm just gonna grab this healer and try and get more gold. And we can go for Broken Myth next for our last item. I could just sell that right now. I don't even need that anymore. I'm gonna go and get... Oh, never mind. I already took that. Dang. I want to go and get Ambien if they hadn't took it yet, but that's alright. Looks like they're trying to fight. Looks like they're fighting around the jungle. We should be able to get someone here. Oh, we can definitely get Silvernail. Oh, Silvernail's so low. He's about to ultimate me. I'm gonna dodge it. Oh. That was just a second late. I should still be able to get him. Oh my god, that tripwire. It's gonna be so annoying. Nice, I still got him. Let's see if... looks like our team's just been cleaning up too. We should just back off here and go for mid turret. Yep, there's that. We could try and go for armory too, I guess. Might as well. Are we gonna be able to end here? I highly doubt it, to be honest. Can definitely get two armories, but... I'm gonna have to back off there. Nice, actually we should be able to end now, maybe. Oh, never mind. We definitely cannot do this. I'm just gonna run. But pretty much in that last fight, I knew that Silvernail was gonna ultimate, but I just predicted it a little bit too early. He held on to it for a little bit longer than. Holy crap, is Lyra gonna live? Dude, this Lyra is a god. You should want this Lyra to be your captain. I don't even know how he lived that. But this game has been kind of interesting. Everybody's been taking my CS, but that's fine. Just because I have so many kills, my CS doesn't even matter too much at this point. Even though Scarf and Kinetic have took like half of my CS in my farm. That's alright. Just because my kills make up for it. But I'm gonna go for a block now, just because I have a lot of CC and stuns. And I don't really want to get stunned, to be honest. That's so annoying to get stunned as Reza. But we're just gonna grab these now. And we should be able to fight. But yeah, as I was saying, in that last fight, I knew Silvernail was gonna ultimate. So I tried to use my ultimate right when he would. But I just predicted it a little bit too early. But it's that kind of stuff that you want to pay attention to and that you want to try. We should be able to just kill her. Holy crap, that just got deleted. Where did Malene just go? Wait, what? Oh, Malene's over there. Wait, what? Okay. I'm just gonna ultimate right onto him. They should just get molted. Yeah, Scarf just got all the kills. And now we can just end with this. But that's gonna be it for this video. I just wanted to get some gameplay out, get something out for y'all to watch. Maybe learn from, hopefully, how to predict enemy movements and stuff. How to predict what the enemy's gonna do. But that's gonna be it. Let's try and hit 600 subs with this video. And see you guys next time.